Good morning, everyone. It's May 24, 2019, and I'm back with the Morning Tales. So let's start with the first question for the May 24, 2019. And these are very important for both grade A and grade B. Now let's start with the first question. So what is India's rank in Kids Right Index 2019? So this Kids Right Index actually tells about the improved equipment of the countries with respect to the child rights. And this has been launched by the Kids Right Foundation. So it's important that the Kids Right Foundation has launched this Kids Right Index. And as per this index, out of 181 countries, India has been ranked at 117th position. If you look at the first country, so Iceland is at the first position and the last country is 181. Now, what is important in this question? First of all, India's rank. Second, which country has been ranked at the first position and at the last position as well? And what are the different parameters or indicators being used to calculate or develop this index? So basically, there are five indicators which are being used to develop this Kids Right Index 2019. So first index is right to life. Another indicator is right to education. The third one is right to health. Fourth one is right to protection. And the last one is enabling environment for child rights. So how equipped is the environment for the child right? So these are the different parameters or indicators on which this Kids Right Index has been positioned. Also, India has ranked at 117th position. It's very important to remember this thing. The next question is, Vice President Venkaiah Naidu called for protecting and promoting the indigenous dash cattle breed. So recently, Vice President Venkaiah Naidu, he stressed on promoting the indigenous Ongole cattle breed, and this Ongole cattle breed is based out of Andhra Pradesh. So it's basically indigenous to Andhra Pradesh. Now, this question becomes very important for the NABARD examination and they might ask you about this breed as well. So Venkaiah Naidu, he stressed on promoting these Ongole cattle breed. Now, if you look at some of these stats, so India has total of 37 pure cattle breeds and 5 of these are known with the milking pros. So they are Sahiwal, Gir, Red Sindhi, Tharparkar and Rathi. Also, a question might come on this that Ongole is indigenous to which state? So it's Andhra Pradesh. Moving on to the next question. So which state's municipal corporation has launched the scheme which is known as Antim Yatra Akhri Safar scheme? So the Karim Nagar, which is a district in Telangana, they have launched this scheme which is known as Antim Yatra Akhri Safar scheme. So it has been launched in the state of Telangana. It's a novel scheme where the last rites of the near and dear ones would be performed, or the municipal corporation would be performing the last rites of the person for just rupee one. So it's the rupee one scheme where the rituals, the final rituals, or taking the body to the burial ground and the material required, whatever the last rituals are there for the person, it would be done at the cost of rupee one. And it's a novel scheme which has been launched by Telangana's Karim Nagar. Also, it is available to everyone irrespective of the religion and caste. So basically, those who are willing to avail the scheme have to just pay 1 rupee and collect the receipt, and rest of the rituals would be provided by the, or would be done by the municipal corporation. Next question is, which ministry confers the Vayoshreshth Samman? So Vayoshreshth Samman is basically the national award for the senior citizen. So for the senior citizen, so a question might come on the purpose of this Vayoshreshth Samman, and it is for the senior citizen. So basically it's being conferred upon those citizens and institutions where they have done or they have provided services to the elderly persons. Now, this National Award for Senior Citizens is being provided or done by the Department of Social Justice and Empowerment, which is under the Ministry of Social Justice and Empowerment. So it was basically started in the year 2005, and now they are announcing the nominations till May 31st. Also, there is a fixed date for this award. It becomes important because there is a fixed date that on October 1st, this National Award for Senior Citizens is being announced. The awardees are being announced. So why October 1st is being observed as the day on which this national award is being given? So it's being observed on this day because it is observed as the International Day of Older Persons on October 1st. So the International Day of Older, so how many questions could be framed that the ministry which is responsible, they are known for the National Award for Senior Citizens, the purpose, why they are given. It was launched in 2005 and it's being conferred on October 1st. Reason being that it is, the day is observed as the International Day of Older Persons. The next question is, which country has launched the Golden Card, a permanent residency scheme? So, a permanent residency scheme basically to woo the wealthy investors. So, this country has launched this scheme to woo the wealthy investors, and they expect that the different talents and the investors would be attracted and come to their nation. So, under this Golden Card, the general investors would get the 10-year visa, and the real estate investors would be getting the 5 years visa. And for this purpose, two Indian businessmen have become the first from the community to get the 10-year UA visa. And who are they? So basically, Vasu Shroff and Khushi Katwani, they have been honored, or they are being given this 10-year visa, UA visa, and or they are honored with this Golden Card scheme, that is the permanent residency scheme of UAE. Important to remember that the Golden Card is the name which is being taken by UAE for their 10-year permanent residency scheme. The next question, an important one. So according to the World Economic Situation Prospects 2019, remember this is mid-year update, and India is projected to grow at, so basically in January 2019, they predicted the forecast to be 7.4% for the fiscal 2020. But this time they have projecting it to be 7.1%. So according to this prospects report, the India is projected to grow at 7.1% in 2020. Also for 2019, the projection is 7%. So 7% for 2019 and 7.1% for 2020. Remember this thing, it's very important. Next question is, winner of the 2019 Man Booker International Prize. So Man Booker International Prize, it's an important award. So it focuses on the writers outside the English language area. This is very important. It focuses on non-English or outside the English horizon. And for the first time, the Omani transaction or the female Omani author has been honored with this 2019 Man Booker International Prize, Zoka Alaharty. Now she has been honored for her novel Celestial Bodies. So a question might come for the novel as well, or the person who has been honored with the Man Booker International Prize, that is Zoka Alaharty. She is from Oman. Now there are two questions for you. So where will be the Shanghai Cooperation Organization 2019 meet be held? The place, you need to tell the place. It's the Foreign Ministers Meeting, and it is to be conducted in the month of May 2019. So where will be the Shanghai Cooperation Organization be held? You need to mention that in the comment section. Also, the another question is, when is the World No Tobacco Day observed? So on which day World No Tobacco Day is observed? Mention that as well in the comment section. Do not forget to download the Spotlight from the website. The link is available in the description. You have to just go through the Spotlight and you'll be done with the current affairs for the upcoming NABARD examination. And do not forget to subscribe to our channel as well. Also, press the bell icon so that you do not miss on any of the updates as well. Thank you so much for watching the video.